Okay. It's the end of the summer of 1961. Sparky, my older brother, is flying back to Princeton in the morning, and I'm flying back to Choate 2 days after that. We're eating lunch, and he turns to me and he says, "Dipshit, I think it would do you a lot of good to go say goodbye to Katie in person. It was really uncool the way she broke up with you on the phone, you know? Put some closure on things." Homer drove me over, and I'm standing at the door talking to Katie when I hear a voice behind her go, "Who's that at the door, Katie?" It was Katie's mom. And suddenly she's there with Katie. And I'm standing there smiling at both of them, feeling awkward, but just come out with, "Well, I just stopped over to say goodbye to Katie before I left for school." Mrs. McAllister says she looks forward to a visit this Christmas, prompting Katie to give me a sisterly hug and tell me goodbye. I walk on down the walk feeling pretty good about myself and slide in next to my brother in the front seat of the station wagon. But he's smoking one of Mom's cigarettes right now, and I think, what the hell? He reaches under his seat and pulls out a fully wrapped string of 1.5-inch black cat firecrackers, 250 little blasters. With a cackle, he yells, "Yeah, goodbye, Katie," lights the string, and throws it across me, aiming out my window into Katie's front yard. What he hadn't figured on was that the window was rolled up. At the same time, he slams the station wagon into gear to make our getaway. The firecrackers hit the glass with a forceful thwack, ricochet off the window, and land between us in the front seat. Like a pan of popcorn on the stove, the muffled explosions inside the car grew to an incredible crescendo. Mother's car is now filled with black smoke and fire as it rolled down the street, still in gear. Homer and I were up and running beside the car as we witnessed the rocket's red glare. The Impala was headed for a fire hydrant at the end of Katie's block on our side of the street. Not good. As I ran, I was pushing on my side of the door as hard as I could in a panic but vain attempt to herd Mom's misguided missile into the middle of the street and away from the curb that housed the fast-approaching fire hydrant. I was repeatedly yelling my brother's name. Homer braved the exploding firecrackers, ripped open the door, stuck his arm into the popcorn popper, and grabbed for the steering wheel. "Got it!" Homer yelled in triumph, just as the front bumper of the station wagon clipped the fire hydrant, sheared it off at street level. I looked back over my shoulder and saw Katie and her mother standing together on the front porch, just as a thundering column of water erupted and put the fire out in Mom's car. That backward look was the last time I ever saw Katie, and thanks to my brother, I'm certain of one thing. Katie would always remember me.